Everything in this video was found on a public domain. Hey, welcome to the Danger Zone. It's Ashley. Lots of love and many blessings your way. If these two people had a brain between them, they'd be dangerous. These couple of half-wits, oh my God. No sooner had Harry stepped his bare feet off of the private jet returning him back from Sicily when he went to the Google Climate Change camp just to grab his family, supposedly, and hop back on another private jet to Ibiza. Their entire lifestyle ought to be a ginormous bullhorn screaming, "Look at us, we want attention every time we stand up for something. After all, we're humanitarians, planet savers, and philanthropists." God forbid you have more than two children. Don't you dare buy a piece of fruit or a vegetable wrapped in plastic. Start reusing water bottles. There's no sense in you having a new bottle every time you turn around. You do as we say and not as we do. As they were wasting everybody's time with their BS, here's what was really going on. As our overheated planet begins to melt every glacier on a mountaintop from here to Timbuktu and back, they were sitting cozied up on a, yet again, private plane. They went to Ibiza, supposedly, on August 6th, all three of them, like a real family, which I'm not buying, and we'll talk about that in just a second. The planes cost in total about $50,000 coming and going. They do far more damage, in fact, about 10 times the damage than a commercial flight would. Saving the planet was just not a part of that trip, you guys. Evidently, that climate change camp he had just gotten back from meant nothing. How can somebody preach one thing and do another? It blows my mind. Anyway, it's said that they all three went as a family for her birthday, but I'm not buying it. Something's off. You trying to tell me your entire time there, coming and going, not one person had a cell phone to take your picture? God knows they're sneaky, but they're just not that good at it. Typically, when they go places, they'll bring their own security team, but they'll have to call on the local area's security, department. And they said that wasn't needed this trip. It doesn't feel right to me. Something is off. Speaking of something being off, I wanted to tell you guys about their Balmoral visit. Okay, so the Queen has absolutely put her foot down as far as the wardrobe. She told Meghan, "No way, you're not wearing wedges, and you're not showing up in jeans. We're just not going to do things that way. You're going to have to start dressing like a part of the family." William and Kate are so fed up with both Harry and Meghan. Initially, they were going to sit back and allow Meghan and Harry to get through with their vacation, seeing the Queen in Balmoral Castle. I guess the Queen decided she wanted to ask them if they would give it a chance, and they decided they would come up the same time. However, William and Kate are not going to stay anywhere near them. Meghan and Harry are to stay in this castle with the Queen and Prince Philip, and Kate and William have distanced themselves into a cottage on the estate. What was told to me earlier today is this feud between the brothers and their wives is irreconcilable. There's not going to be any kind of sitting around a bonfire talking about memories between them. Not anytime soon, anyhow. There's no trust there, you guys. Do you remember when Meghan was actually busted keeping a diary, and then the staff found the recording that she was keeping of the family having personal, private conversations? She herself was caught on recording talking, oh my God, all kinds of garbage about William, Kate, and their children. You know who folks are really comparing her to now? She's worked so hard trying to be Diana 2.0, but sadly, she's more like Sarah Ferguson. She and Sarah Ferguson both love a dollar bill better than I've ever seen anybody love one in my life. They'll do anything and stop at nothing for that money in the bank. It wasn't too long ago that Sarah Ferguson made a deal with a fake journalist trying to sell Prince Andrew's privacy for £500,000. Let's not forget how close she is with Epstein. He paid her out of debt. We'll talk about that in another video. The point is, they're both pretty much one in the same. Ooh, before I forget, I want to tell you guys what my journalist friend told me. Listen to this. And I want to say thank you. You know who you are. It's no secret that people make a living you know, taking pictures of the royals, watching every move they make, especially journalists. Well, there's a set of journalists that have watched Frogmore Cottage for quite some time and have found it to be a ghost town, but that's neither here nor there. And those same people have watched the grocery deliveries, grocery pickups. They've watched that place like a hawk. Ever since Archie's arrival was made known, they've not witnessed the first baby item purchased, brought in, delivered, taken away. There's no sign of a child. None. Not even the usual diaper delivery service that would typically take place if a child was around. Things for the older kids have been spotted, but absolutely nothing pertaining to an infant. Nothing. Nothing. And like they said, sooner or later a baby's gonna have to be produced. And even though Harry thinks that his wife and his mother would have been thick as thieves today, Harry wasn't even a teenager by the time she passed away. People who knew her better are now saying she would have not only been a bit disappointed with the choices that Meghan and Harry are making, but extremely confused. And it'd be really interesting to know Diana's real feelings on the matter. I personally believe he would have never needed somebody like Meghan to fill that void had his mama not passed away. Also, I wanted to point out another reason why I think that Meghan might not be so active in the family right now as they're making her out to be. The Sussex Royal Instagram account used to have all sorts of the negative deleted and gotten rid of. And here lately, it's remaining. I've been looking through those comments and the nasty ones aren't disappearing. Like she's not manning the site anymore. I had to mention that real quick before it slipped my mind. I find it to be super weird. I'll see you soon. We'll talk fast. Y'all stay safe and be blessed.